And a very good afternoon to you from the splendid Al Tumama Stadium in Doha for today's Group E clash between Jordan and the Korean Republic, the two teams who lead the way in the section as the knockout stage draws near. A win for either today would confirm a round of 16 place. And of course, Japan's shock loss to Iraq yesterday opens up the possibility of an East Asian Classico if Korea Republic were to win the group and the Samurai Blue were to finish second in their section. Jordan will have other ideas, of course, and that is for the future. Conditions today are perfect for football, as you can see. And we are set for a really interesting clash between these two. Jordan are regular competitors these days in the AFC Asian Cup. This is their fifth crack at the regional tournaments, and they've been in the last eight twice, although not since 2007. And 4 years ago, they were hugely disappointed, having won through a tough group involving Australia, to go out to Vietnam on penalties in the round of 16. But they expect to reach at least that stage once again here in Qatar. Expectations, of course, always much higher for the Korean Republic. Their star-studded squad, led by Son Heung-min, rated one of the favourites for the trophy itself. They are currently on a run of seven straight victories. So confidence is high among the Taeguk Warriors as they look to end a 64-year drought at this tournament. In 2019, you might remember they went out to the eventual winners, Qatar, in the quarterfinals. But this is arguably the best Korean Republic squad in living memory. Could it finally be their year? Well, they've got a bit of work to do before they lift the trophy, of course, starting with Jordan here today. They have met five times in the past, and Jordan have never won, although they did draw in their only previous AFC Asian Cup meeting all the way back in 2004, a match that ended goalless between the pair. But they have lost the last three meetings, haven't actually played each other in almost a decade.
Jordan and Korea Republic!
But they are about to lock horns here at the Al Tumama Stadium in Group B of the AFC Asian Cup. A highly anticipated clash. Both teams pretty straightforward winners on match day one. The Korean Republic seeing off Bahrain by 3-1. And Jordan, of course, accounting for Malaysia by 4-0. So top spot in the group is up for grabs in terms of qualification. The winners will go through and finish top of this section. Which one will it be? We're about to find out.
Please rise if you are able for the national anthem of Jordan.
أصحاب السمو والمعالي السيدات والسادة يرجى الوقوف في حالة القدرة لعزف النشيد الوطني للأردن.
Let's get ready to count down to kickoff. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
So it is Jordan in the all-white strip, kicking from left to right on your screens in the first half, who get the ball rolling. Just the 6 metres between the two, and a reminder, as I welcome Andy Harper, Jordan have never beaten the Korean Republic. Could they end that run today? We've seen one or two shocks already.
Yeah, good afternoon, Simon. What a brilliant day it is in Doha again. The weather's pretty consistent. So too, the atmosphere at the stadiums. And this one is very loud. We're not even 30 seconds old. And we watched Iraq give it to Japan yesterday in quite a remarkable game of football. And that's got to be the template for Jordan here today. The relativities apply.
And we've already got a bit of an injury concern from Musa Al-Tamri of Jordan and Hwang In-bom of Korea. Knee on knee. Painful one. It shouldn't be more than a surface graze for both.
It will be interesting today, Simon, to see if Jordan take anything out of the Iraq performance yesterday. Jordan haven't come into this tournament with the sort of form that Iraq could refer to. They certainly haven't, on the first evidence, got the same quality through the squad, but they match up in plenty of other ways. And I just wonder if, like Iraq yesterday against Japan, they will go at Korea early and try and establish themselves in the match and upset the favourites' equilibrium, which Iraq were just magnificent at doing yesterday. Got the goals as a reward.
Well, one battle to keep an eye on is Musa Al-Tamri, who's off the pitch at the moment after that injury, but will be back on in just a moment, up against Lee Ki-jeer, who is replacing the injured Kim Jin-soo at left-back, and a lot of Korean supporters feel as though that is a bit of a weak link in the Korean team. In fact, both full-back areas. Yeah. Well, Sol, who's on the ball now, is more naturally a more attacking player.
Well, in Lee Ki-jeer, you've got a very tenacious left fullback.
Well, here come the Koreans. Lee Jae-sung on the left. Plenty of Jordanian fans, of course, in the stand, as you can hear. He will give it to the Koreans at every possibility. Led off by Sung Hoon-min. And then played out wide right. Lee Kang-in's going to fire away, but no problems for Yazid Abulela in the Jordanian goal with that one.
Yeah, so in Lee Ki-jeer, just to finish that point, as one of the superstars of the team, Lee Kang-in set square for goal. I think he got the second loudest cheer when they did the teams up after Captain Song Hyun-min. He is an incredible player, and he's going to be a real handful for Jordan down their left-hand side. But in Lee Ki-jeer, Simon, given the quality of the Korea Republic squad, he's a rare beast playing in a second-tier competition. Everywhere else, they're strewn largely through Europe, but some through Asia, etc.
Well, in fairness, he wasn't last season. Two on Blue Wings got relegated last season.
Sure, and has changed clubs since. So, but the point remains. I was fascinated by some of your introductory statements. The pressure on this team is the most talented squad in recent memory. And then you think back to the 2002 World Cup semi-finals, and you go through that list of players, and you think, wow, that does put some pressure on this squad. Park Ji-sung, Hyung Myung-bo, Ahn Jun-won, remember the young starlet from that particular squad? I mean, you read through that 2002 team and it is eye-watering.
Here come the Koreans. Son Jung-min, he goes down inside the box. Referee has a look at it and says corner. Well, that's an interesting talking point. Son looks pleadingly at the referee. Of course, he'll be taking advice from VAR. Let's have another look at this one, Andy.
Yeah, well, it's a great incursion. He's got to have got the ball here.
I don't think he does.
My first reaction is penalty. I don't know how they're going to survive this one, Jordan.
I think that's going to be a penalty, but we shall see.
And speaking of quality, I mean, Song Joong-min very obviously is one who would fit pretty nicely into that 2002 roster.
The only other question mark, of course, is whether Son was offside going through it. I think he was, but we wait. Abdullah Al-Mahdi in the VAR booth, running the rule over the pictures. And for me, Hassan Haddad does not get the ball and clearly collects Song Hyung-min. anxious wait for the coaches. They are poring forensically over the pictures to try and deduce whether the Jordanian captain fouled his opposite number. And still the wait goes on.
Well, he's making his way somewhat tentatively towards halfway on the video monitor. He's called for a corner kick here. So he's going to have to come and look at the monitor if there's going to be a change. And he's making his way slowly, step by step by step. Only to arrive at what for everyone else was the inevitable outcome.
Well, he's been asked to come and have a look at the pictures in the tunnel. Oh dear. Hassan Haddad spotted the danger of Son Heung-min, maybe a fraction too late. But he's so difficult to keep tabs on, isn't he?
Yeah, incredible player.
Let's see if he does actually make any contact with the ball. Didn't look like it to the naked eye.
Well, the point is now, Simon, is the video replays have to incontrovertibly turn over the referee's view. Beyond doubt, is there evidence to state unequivocally that the referee got this wrong?
Well, to me, that comes off the right boot of Son Heung-min. And Haddad clearly takes out his left.
Yeah, well, I think that's the pitcher that is going to condemn Jordan to seeing away a penalty.
That one looks a little bit more less clear-cut, if that's the right way.
Completely. Which is the definitive angle? Who has the say on that in the VAR room?
Well, that's down to Abdullah Almari. They're having a long, old discussion about this.
Well, that angle that we just saw.
And he's certainly not offside. That's out of the window.
Well, they'll do their thing. We're merely spectators in this great theatre. Theatre which could just use a little bit of a hurry up.
On cue, they sped up the pictures for you, Andy. And still, the debate goes on. Well, at some point, we've got to have a decision. Here it comes. Lengthy discussion. Penalty. And I think the right outcome has been arrived at. And the next discussion, of course, is what colour card. It's a yellow for Hassan Haddad. But the Korean Republic have a penalty kick. Jurgen Klinsmann unmoved on the sideline. Hussein Amuta just asking for clarification. The Jordan fans are going to do their very best to put off Son Heung-min.
Well, so is Musa Al-Tamari. Requested trip to encourage his goalkeeper, Yazid, who faces one of the world's finest from the penalty spot.
And Son Heung-min playing in his fourth Asian Cup final series. Didn't score in the 2019 edition. Did not score on match day one against Bahrain. But he's going to take the captain's responsibility here up against Yazid Abulayla. Big moments early on at the Al Tumama. And Son Heung-min with a little penenka opens the scoring for the Korean Republic. It's his first goal in the Asian Cup Finals since scoring in the final against Australia in Sydney in 2015.
Yeah, well, this one's a hammer blow for Jordan. Unable to establish that foothold to which we earlier referred. He's in fine form at the moment, Son Heung-min. Flying for Tottenham. And just dropping that one over the sprawling Yazid to give Korea the lead.
It's his 42nd goal at international level. Edges him a bit closer to Hwang Sun-hong, In second place on the all-time list with 50, the legendary Cha Bum Kun, the all-time leader with 58 goals. And his mere presence caused panic for Hassan Haddad and the Jordanian defence.
Well, he needed to make the challenge. I mean, cut it every way you want. It was, in my opinion, a clear penalty, but he had to make an effort at the ball. If he doesn't put the challenge on, Sion Heung-min just slots it past the keeper, probably, or goes around him. It's an unfortunate must-have that he just got wrong. Although, by the length of the deliberation, he only just got it wrong. Hassan Haddad.
It's the worst possible start for the team nicknamed Al Nashama, the Brave. And they are going to have to be brave now.
It's been an incredible run to the tournament under Jurgen Klinsmann. His reign didn't start that convincingly. Didn't win for the first few matches. They haven't stopped winning since. Jordan Khan bear the same testimony of their preparation. It's been a tough road to hoe.
Well, here come Jordan. This is Abdullah Nassib. And towards Hassan Haddad. Eager to atone for the concession of that penalty. Jordan will want to get Musa Al-Tamri on the ball as early as possible and as often as possible. But this is Cho Kyu-sung for the Koreans. Lee Kang-in on the right. Park Yong-woo. And turned back by Lee Ki-jae. Up by the Jordanians, but stealing in is Son Heung-min. Walked out wide to the Korean captain again, who is full of confidence. And that one missed by quite some distance.
Yeah, here's the penalty. Calmly taken. From a player and captain at the peak of his powers.
And holds up the jersey of the stricken goalkeeper. Kim Sung-kyu, who unfortunately had to leave camp this week after tearing his ACL. What a horrible moment to pick up such a bad injury when your team is fancied by so many to have a run deep into this tournament. But his replacement has not been tested as yet. There is Musa Al-Tamri. Jordan's biggest star playing in Ligue 1 with Montpellier. Playing regularly too and contributing. Three goals and one assist in his first 15 games in France. Broken up by the Koreans. Park Yong-woo got himself into a little spot of bother there and he's relieved perhaps to get the referee's whistle to get him out of a tight spot. Turned into a bit of a cul-de-sac here, but Yazan Al-Naimat just a little bit heavy in that tackle. Turned over by Lee Kang-in. Here is Musa Al-Tamri. Getting forward on the right was Hassan Haddad. That was the intended ball, but too many defenders back.
Well, still very much a carnival atmosphere inside this very well attended stadium. Brilliant sight. Fans gathering outside today, making their way into the stadium, just creating an enormous expectation, celebration. The classic mixing of the cultures. One's overhit, which is a real feature of the Asian Cup. There's such diversity across the region and the Confederation. Every game pretty much presents a classic juxtaposition. We've got that here today. Korean fans very excited at what this team might do. The Jordan fans steeled. They'll be needing the Dabukas to be firing up now along with their voices to push the team to greater heights. They'll need it, Jordan.
Quarter finalists twice in the AFC Asian Cup. The Jordanians, 2004 and 2007. Got out of the group 4 years ago before losing on penalties to Vietnam.
Even so, in pre-tournament, Jordan would have looked at the group and budgeted perhaps for a containment of the Korea Republic, with the qualification coming down to the match against Bahrain. Malaysia might have some say on that later on.
Nice bit of skill from Haddad.
Nevertheless, still very important for Jordan. Their own mindset and confidence to give a good account for themselves. Beautiful work there by the skipper. Some Haddad. Listen to this.
Yeah, Jordan have got the bulk of the fans inside the stadium. There's no doubt about that. Klinsmann, wouldn't say he's universally popular in the Korean Republic. He bases himself out of Europe, which hasn't gone down too well in some quarters. Any feeling that he should be in the Korean Republic? That's offside against Lee Jae-sung. By quite some distance as well. Is Abdallah Nasi sending the ball long. Helped on by Anamat. Oh, and Al-Tabri. And the whistle has gone Korea's way. Two players with a genuine challenge for the ball. And it's Al-Tabri that's been penalised. And a yellow card as well. I have to say, at first glance, I tend to feel that was a 50-50 ball. But the replay may tell a different story. Jung Sung-hyun, the Korean defender. Let's have another look at it. Yeah, he's a fraction late.
Yeah. Yeah. But nothing malicious. Just a careless challenge. Trying to wave away the decision, but of course he can't. The yellow card sticks.
This is Jung Sung-hyun. Gets the head up and pings one out towards Lee Jae-sung. He plays his club football in Germany for Mainz. Sol Yong-woo for Lee Kang-in, who had three Jordanians around him. And now they'll look to release Yazan Al-Naimat. Being well dealt with, comfortably so, by the Korean Republic. Sent long by Jung Sung-hyun. Son Heung-min. Oh, Abdallah Nasib. Left a little bit in on that challenge with Son.
Now there's plenty of close attention to the Jordan players. Korea handling the physicality well. It's great application from Jordan, working really hard across the field. Al-Tamari asking for a little bit of support, but their midfielder dropped to complete the block with the back line.
Up for a ball from Lee Kijia. Lee Kang-in is away from one defender. Slides it towards Lee Jae-sung. Big chance for the Koreans to get two. But the shot is blocked, and Son Heung-min is denied a second goal. But it was beautifully constructed.
Well, just look on the screen here. Hassan Haddad, is he pulled out of the way there or milked it? Referee says play on. If there's a foul there, which the captain Haddad is still, the case for which he's still prosecuting, and it's extra pressure in defending the corner that Jordan shouldn't have to face. Good point. As the game goes on.
Now watch out for the tall figure of Kim Min-jae to make his move from this corner. Known as the monster, 6 foot three. There's got plenty of height. Nice tail on it. Kim Min-jae did go for it. Breaks Jordan's way. And Musa Al-Tamri gets the better of one challenge. It's good cover. Really excellent defending by the aforementioned Kim Min-jae.
Wasn't it a great scramble? And just couldn't get the ball cleanly to Musa Al-Tamri. But the speed with which the Korea Republic players look to swarm Jordan's talisman tells you everything you need to know about the danger he poses. So there's reacting when you lose the ball as quickly as you can to win it back. And there's reacting with the ferocity that the Korea Republic players did then to make sure Musa Al-Tamri couldn't hurt them.
Here is Al-Tamri. Oh, and the first real save in anger for Jo Kyung-woo. Something out of nothing from Musa Al-Tamri. That's what he's capable of. And it needed a good stop.
And cue the talisman. Forewarned his forearm for the Korea Republic. That's why they're trying to stuff him out. And as hard as they worked then, they couldn't deny him the shot on goal. And Joe beats the ball away at the near post gratefully.
And Al-Tamri delivers the corner, and it's headed over the top of the near post by Yazan Al-Naimat. Wasn't a bad idea to go low and flat towards the near post.
He did well, stooped. Yeah, but it's been a good period for Jordan. Not going into their shells. Never would we expect it from the years we've been watching Jordan play. Never have they gone into their shells. This time 4 years ago, they were flying high at the group stage, of course, beating Australia 1-0 and Syria 2-0. Quite unexpectedly, their campaign came unstuck in the penalty shootout in the round of 16 against Vietnam. Very deflating for them after starting so well. And they're in a boisterous mood here, backed by this huge crowd.
Yeah, latecomers still taking their seats. Stadium that holds in excess of 44,000. I reckon we might be close to 30 inside the venue. Off the chest of Lee Jae-sung, who then slipped. Picked up in midfield here by Rajai Ayet. Forward towards Al-Naimat. And Jordan will get the free kick. And I think they're asking Salman Fulahi for a yellow card as well. I think they're going to be disappointed in that regard there. Jung Sung Kyun certainly going over the top of his opponent. And again, the Jordanians find their voices in the stands. Maybe another test for the goalkeeper on Asian Cup Finals debut. Although it's 32, he's not exactly inexperienced. And the K-League best 11 the last 7 seasons. Al-Tamri's free kick. And Arab. Looking to nod the ball towards goal. And the final touch came off Lee Ki-je. A little bit unnecessarily for the Korean Republic.
They've had a good 5 minutes or so, Jordan. A series of plays into the attacking penalty area. Free kick, couple of corners. A good save forced from Joe by Musa Al-Tamri. It's quite the battle around the penalty spot. There's a clutch of very big human beings pushing and cajoling for supremacy.
Yazan Al-Arab is taking on 2 of them. And forming a human shield for his teammates. Maybe you can just deduce from that that the Koreans are a little bit rattled. Al-Tamri taps it short. The delivery from Mahmoud Al-Mahdi is way, way, way over hits. Disappointing for Al-Nashama.
Well, that's an understatement, Simon. Way, way was way more than way, way. That was gone, gone. What a shame. In the short term for Jordan, it had really built a nice little bit of pressure there on the Korea Republic, and they come again. Excellent. Cho can't bring that ball down on halfway.
And this is Rajai Ayet. Now Yazan Al-Arab. And It's got the legs to get through to his captain, Hassan Haddad. Now Nassi. Touch around the corner from Al Rashda for Al Arab. Back by Al Naimat and Al Ajilid will go long. Ali Olan with a little set up, but couldn't quite find his teammate. And steered back by Lee J. Sung. Chokyu Sung is a big, tall centre forward in the old fashioned mould. 6 foot two, 6 foot three. He's going to have quite the battle with Yazan Alara.
It's a good one. I mean, you've already used Kim Min Jae's moniker, the monster. But I have to say, I look at Yazan Alara sharing your predilection for the man bun. And he, to me, looks like a monster as well. That's a brutal contest, he versus Joe. And it's probably even Steven at the moment. And again, it's Jordan who settled on the ball.
It's going to be a free kick for Japan. Wu collected by Al Naimat. He believed that he was held back prior to that.
It's a heavy clash too. And they're charging in, closing down space. And fearless. Personal challenge stakes. Jordan, Korea standing their ground. Despite the lead earned by the Korea Republic, it's a very tense start to the game.
So Yong Woo's ball has just drifted all the way through to Yazid Abulele in the Jordan goal. Here's Al-Tamiri. Lee Ki-jae sticking tight to the winger, but he's got clear of him now. Danger for the Korean Republic. It's Musa Altamiri. That's going to be a card. That's going to be a yellow card for Hwang In-bom. Easiest decision of the afternoon so far for Salman Fellahi, the referee.
There are some things, or plenty of things in football, Simon, you can't coach. And the great players show you those things very often. Just on halfway there, the instinct Musa Altamiri showed to not get sucked into challenges, to just keep his space, read the available opportunity and then burst away. It was just beautiful to watch. And brought down unceremoniously by Hwang In-bom, which presents the Montpellier man with a chance for a direct shot on goal, is going to be my tip. Just enjoy watching him play.
Yeah, he's a super player. And Hussein Amuta will be pleased with the way his team has responded after the concession of that early penalty converted by Son Heung-min. And they've got a big chance here. And Jo Kyung-woo on red alert. A wall of five for the Korean Republic. Tap short and well, it's a save for the cameras off Mahmoud Al-Mahdi, but effective nonetheless. Pushed away to safety.
It's safety first. That's exactly the word, Simon. Safety first. Running the risk of any fumbles. With strong hands rather than soft to beat the ball away.
Off the head of Son Heung-min. Oh, and that's a nasty collision. Al Arab arriving. I don't think he meant it.
No, but you've got to take more care. And that's the monster.
He goes into the book as well.
There was not a millisecond where he wasn't going to go for that ball. But it did put an opposing player in real danger. It's heavy head contact as well. Hwang In-bom.
There's the previous action, the free kick hit by Mahmoud Al-Mahdi and pushed away by Jo Hyun-woo.
Provides for a great pitch-up. Maintenance of a clean sheet for the Korea Republic.
So three yellow cards already. The Korean Republic, incidentally, a lot of the talk in the build-up to this game was about the fact that Jurgen Klinsmann's side have got a whole clutch of players carrying yellow cards. Hwang In-bom was not one of them. course, two yellow cards accrued equal to one game suspension. Son Heung-min is one of those. So they just have to be a little bit careful. Says Kim Min-jae, who's made a really good start to life in the German Bundesliga with Bayern Munich after, of course, winning the Serie A title with Napoli last season. Park Yong-woo.
That's very, very good defending from Jordan. The back line is very active, very mindful. Dropping when they need, squeezing the line up. Closer to halfway to compress the space. They're primed, Jordan. Really primed. A question which must be posed is, how long can they remain like this?
It's a clever lead by Almadi, and he's in position for the return. This is Nizar Al-Rashdan. Out towards Hassan Haddad. Now Al-Tamri teasing and tormenting Lee Ki-jae. The Korean Republic defence well structured, no way through on that occasion for Al-Tamri. This is Al-Arab. That's a clever leave from Lee Jae-sung, relieves that bit of pressure.
A little bit of a waste, that pass from Hassan. Gives Korea another opportunity. Look how tight the marking is. Abdullah Nasib just flying in there. At this point in time, Son Heung-min has felt a little bit healthier than he is right about now.
He made sure he wasn't going anywhere, didn't he?
They've been really focused, really committed.
Maybe a little bit fortunate not to get a yellow card for that.
Correct.
Jung Sung-hyun, Sol Yong-woo, looking for the run of Lee Kang-in. There's a little nudge there into the back of Salem Al-Ajlan.
They've done a brilliant job, Jordan, in just ensuring that the Korea Republic cannot get into any rhythm. There's the push in the back, correctly called. Chance now for the Korea Republic to keep Jordan penned into their own territory.
Lee Jae-sung to Lee Ki-jae. Kim Min-jae happy to go back to his goalkeeper. Korean Republic, two-time winners of the AFC Asian Cup, but all the way back in 1956 and then again 4 years later in 1960. They've been to the final on a few occasions, but it's remarkable they haven't won the trophy since then. And they've got some defending to do here. That took a deflection, I think. No. Goal kick. And not a bad try by Ali Olwan.
Just amazing energy and verve. And a slight claims for a foul there on by the Korea Republic players, but great burst, lovely touch by Hassan Al-Naimah to set up the final shot on goal, which was wayward, unfortunately. Ali Olwan. Some great chances being created here.
It's been a good open contest. Nine shots, just slightly favouring Jordan at the moment, but Korean Republic with that vital early goal. Penalty spot converted by Son Heung-min.
It might be a bit early to draw this comparison, Simon, but you look at three West Asian teams who've played three heavyweights from East Asia. Syria made it very difficult for Australia. Iraq did their business yesterday against Japan. And now Jordan continuing that trend. despite the fact that they're trailing on the scoreboard, they've clearly got the football in supremacy at the moment. Look at this pressure. It's incessant from Jordan.
The Korean Republic out of that press, but just not accurate enough with the release for Lee Jae-sung through the middle.
They want this tournament, AFC Asia Cup, Qatar 2023, is proving is that the competitive field is equalising drastically, tournament by tournament.
Musa Montamri with a floated ball towards the edge of the Korean Republic box. The scraps picked up here by Al Naimat. Now Musa Montamri leaves it for Ali Olwan. And behind them is Rajai Ayets. Now Al Arab. Good possession for Jordan. Lifted into the box, and it needed that touch from the Korean defender, and then he inadvertently tripped his own goalkeeper, and it's going to be a Jordan corner.
It's a brilliant play. It's composed. It's full of passion. It's full of belief. It's full of energy. And there's a lot of quality as Jordan are winning the ball and then playing around and through the Korean Republic.
Al Tamari's corner. Back post was Abdallah Nasib. It's going to be another corner from the other side.
Unbelievable pressure being built. Korea Republic standing tall and strong in the face of this onslaught. That's the only word you can use to describe it. It's an onslaught.
And they're lifting the noise volume in the stands. It's going to be Mahmoud Al-Mahdi to deliver. Al Arab and Nasib waited to make their move in towards the near post, and it's there! It's Yazan Al Arab at the back stick. The somersaults to celebrate the equaliser for Jordan from the big defender. 1-1.
Well, he's going to claim it. The Jordanians don't care, but it's an own goal. It's monster on monster. Yazan Al Arab, too much of a physical presence. And for a big guy, he doesn't do the gymnastics half bad either.
Well, but the pressure, they deserve that.
They do deserve it completely. And the pressure on Kim Min-jae, the other monster. Serie A winner with Napoli. Now flying with Bayern Munich, and he was reduced to scoring an own goal on the far post from the defensive corner. It's just been brilliant from Jordan. And this tournament is delivering again. And they have taken the leaf out of Iraq's approach to Japan yesterday, and they've got their award.
Now Al-Arab has to do some defending, and out comes Yazid Abu Layla. With a dive and a catch for the cameras.
Wow, how's this one set up now? Just brilliant. Thoroughly deserved equaliser. Korea Republic shell-shocked. Can't get the ball, can't hold the ball. And they're being run past and through.
Here's Al Naimat. Has Al Tamari for support. Jordan pressing to take the lead. Korea have three defenders in front of him. Al Naimat to tee it up. Rajai Ayet, second go at it. Desperate defending by the Koreans. Al-Ajalin deflected behind, another corner for Jordan.
Incredible. Incredible. Listen to this. And look at that.
Yeah, clear on goal from Kim Min-jae.
Reasons to believe. Well, thankfully, the crowd noise has now exceeded the pre-game hype music reel. The place is bursting at the seams. The Korea Republic are on the rack.
Let's see if Al-Mahdi can put in a similar sort of delivery. Now they scatter. I think he was looking for Al-Tamari. Son Heung-min was there for Korea. But look at the determination from Abdallah Nasib. That epitomises their fight back.
Mate, it's high fives all round. It's quite something to experience this. Proud football team, making their country people very proud. and horse, I'd say, on the way there too. By half-time, bit of quality from Son Heung-min.
Just held up for a moment, still got the ball though. And he's blocked off by Ol Rushton. It's going to be a free kick for the Koreans. And they need a bit of respite.
That's the word, respite. If I'm the Korea Republic, I'm going to take a bit of time to get this free kick back in play. They need a breather. They need to take some of the wind out of Jordan's sails.
Here's Lee Kang-in, Paris Saint-Germain winger. Tight control, but three defenders around him. It's a helping hand from Hwang In-bop. Back for Jung Sung-kyun. And now Kim Min-jae. Game set up beautifully now. Jung Sung-kyun again. Lee Kang-in. I think he was thinking about the next pass.
And no hanging around. Jordan, no. They've got the foot on the throat. Now's the time. Let's just keep pushing. Keep running. Keep tackling.
Give it away. Lee Jae-sung can control it. This is Cho Kyu-sung. And a free kick for the Korean Republic. And this spells danger for Jordan with Son Heung-min more than capable of firing one in from this range.
Well, the question the Jordan players are asking, quite reasonably, I think, this is clearly a foul. There's no question about that. But there was significant interference on Abdullah Nasib 15 metres upfield in the previous contest. I thought it was a foul on the Jordan defender.
But this notwithstanding, this is a chance, make no mistake.
An amazing chance, really out of nowhere. They've been completely blanketed, the Korea Republic. And now with a chance to break clear.
Nazit Abulela setting the wall of five to make sure that near post is guarded as much as it possibly can be. Son Heung-min has a wand of a right foot. Looks like the two Korean players are almost posing for the cameras.
Japanese players did this in their defensive wall yesterday, trying to work out the advantage that they're getting.
Well, let's see. Lee Jae-sung is there as well. And I fancy this is going to be Son. It is Son Heung-min, and he fires wide. And they want to corner the Korean Republic. They're going to be disappointed.
Well, there's not many people in the stadium at the moment, Simon. Oh yeah, did take off the scapula of the animal, the beast, the monster. Call him what you will, he's formidable. Oh, what a thoroughly worthwhile experience this has been. Just a pulsating 43 minutes, right from kickoff. Remember, in the centre circle, about 15 seconds in was that challenge. Sort of set the tone, and it's just not abated. Incredible atmosphere here.
Son Heung-min. It's not a good ball from Park Young-wook. Jordan back on the ball. It's Salem Al-Ajali to Yazan Al-Arab, looking for and finding beautifully Musa Al-Tamari. Haddad on the overlap ahead of him, couldn't quite thread it through. Still there for Rajai Ayet. Al-Tamari again. Ayet looking for options, turns back towards Nasib. Now Al-Arab. Nasib. Throw in for Jordan. Well, he's out of his seats, looking a little bit more fretful than he was in the early minutes, Jürgen Klinsmann. Smith's throw was not read by any of his teammates. And he's determined enough to win the ball back from his team.
Well, it's the first half that completely fits play to the form line coming into the tournament. Jordan had won 3 from 12 coming in here, including a 6-1 loss against Japan. When you consider Jordan's record loss in international football is by 6 goals, 6-0, that says where the team has been, and to get them to where they are on the cusp of halftime here is quite remarkable. What a performance.
I'll tell you what, Andy, that's the first, I've just heard the PA announce that there's 8 additional minutes. The first time I've looked at the clock. That's how good the first half has been. And we're grateful to the officials for giving us another 8 minutes of it.
Well, they did take their time over that penalty. The VAR booth with the referee. Pitch side on the screen. The stadium and Asia waited with bated breath. Didn't put Song Hyun-min off his job. Convincingly nailed the opportunity to give the Korea Republic the lead. But pretty much since then, it's been a whitewash.
Here's Kim Min-jae. Kwang-in-bom. Held up by Nasib. And Kim Min-jae's ball. Behind Lee Jae-sung, and the double teapot from Jurgen Klinsmann tells you all you need to know.
Well, he's got a bit of work to do at half-time, Jurgen the Great. I wonder if he'll break into a North London dialect from his Spurs days and try and get into Son's ear. How do we get out of this one?
If he arrived by Volkswagen. His favourite car. This is Cho Kyu-sung. Long way out. Never really had control of it.
No, and again, to me that's an indication of just how rattled the Korea Republic are. That's a break from normal transition. He's got two players right to his left. He's off balance. Cho shoots anyway. And they've been rattled. Rattled out of their lead. And probably fortunate to still be level. I say probably because of the back of this huge performance from Jordan, it hasn't necessarily meant they've laid siege to Korea's goal. Nevertheless, they've clearly been the better of the two teams. It's been another wonderful performance from a team, according to the form guide, was going to be up against it.
Down with a searching ball for Altamari. Lee Ki-je is there for the Korean Republic. Son wins it in the air. Now gets moving. Has one defender, but just, I think Al Rashdan did enough to put him off. It's a real scrap for the ball. No foul in there. The back heel from Al Naimat. Haddad. In the back from Altamari. Lee Jae-sung. He's such a good player, isn't he?
I feel fortunate that he's been playing on our side of the field in this first half. Just beautiful touches. He's a magician. Montpellier got their hands on a good one there.
2 goals against Malaysia on match day one. Same for Mahmoud Omadi. They've been giving a helping hand here against the Korean Republic. Or helping foot by Kim Min-jae.
Simon, you said, presuming Korea win, Bahrain do their bit, it's Korea, Republic, Japan in the round of 16. Have you considered if Jordan win this match?
Absolutely. Of course.
Well, you're ahead of most people. I think they would have made this a banker. Korea to finish top of the group. Top of the group. They can't even finish top in this half at the moment. They're fighting hard to try and do it. Their spiritual leader trying to show the way. Song Hyun-min.
Here's Al Naimat. Threads it through. Altamari's away. Here come Jordan. Through the legs of the defender, Musa Altamari goes down. says, nothing doing. Well, you thought for all money he was going to pull the trigger and Jordan were going to be 2-1 in front. VAR's going to have a look at it, of course. Al-Tamari felt he was dragged out.
Well, so may I apologise for my outburst. What a pass that was. And I'm like you, you're waiting for him to toe-poke it at this point. I'm not sure that there's enough from Kim Min-jae on the first inspection. The pressure on Al-Tamari is slightly from behind, but here I'm just waiting for him to toe-poke, and he hesitates. He's trying to draw the foul.
He does have a little grab at his shirt there, Kim Min-jae, but not enough to overturn the on-field decision. Here they come again. Musa Al-Tamari sets himself nicely. Al-Naimat, it's there for Jordan! Yazan Al-Naimat! Another extraordinary story brewing here at the Al-Tumama. The Korean Republic, one of the big favourites for the tournament. Trail 2-1 in first half stoppage time. And Jordan have been great value for that lead.
Well, I hate to say I see it, but I don't believe it. Except that we saw it yesterday. And it's a rasping finish, really so difficult to control that as it drops. But he guides it with unerring technique, rifling the ball off the bounce into the far post. Yazan Al-Naimat, the architect of that defence-splitting pass, which set up the whole attack. The Musa Al-Tamari attempt on goal, which resulted in the corner. The Korea Republic, hands on hips, wondering what has happened here in the first half. And they have been completely blitzed by Jordan in quite a remarkable half of Asian Cup football.
Well, penny for the thoughts of the Koreans in the stands when Son Heung-min stroked home that penalty in the opening minutes. You perhaps thought it was going to be a routine day at the office for the Taegeuk Warriors. Not so. What a comeback. What a fighting nation Jordan are. No wonder they are named Al-Nashama the Brave. They have been supremely courageous. Here's Lee Jae-sung. The Koreans shell-shocked at the moment.
Well, post-game yesterday, Iraq coach said, there's no such thing as the perfect performance, but I think today, against Japan, we were almost close to perfect. And I think Jordan, and we said at the top of the call, will they take a leaf out of Iraq's book? I think they have, and they've gone one better. This is even closer to perfect. They have been unerring. They've been passionate. They've been high quality. And now they have the lead.
Remember, the Korean Republic on a run of 7 consecutive victories, unbeaten in 9 matches. They've scored 23 goals in that 9-game unbeaten run and conceded just the 1 goal prior to today. And yet Jordan, a team who've never beaten the Korean Republic, have them on the rack. Still a long way to go, of course. This may be the last chance of the first half. Lee Ki-jae for the Korean Republic. Now with Lee Kang-in, but just shrugged off the ball with ease by Al-Rashda. And we played almost 9 minutes of additional time in the first half. Towards Sol Yong-woo, gets the return off Hwang In-bom. Nice little angle ball inside for Lee Jae-sung. Only partly away, Al-Arab gets greater distance on it. They can't protect the ball though. Son Heung-min couldn't control it. When he's having problems controlling the ball, you know there's an issue. It's Still time, perhaps, for one last Korean Republic attack in this first half. Shifted in field for Kwang Inbom. Crossfield it goes. Lee Ki-jae sets himself beaten away, and Cho has ruined the follow-up opportunity. Hit it into the ground, and the bounce took it over the top of the bar.
Good hit from Lee Ki-jae. The referee's found an extra 2 minutes on top of the eight. It's just expired. It's now half-time. And what a denouement this would have been.
What a first half we've had here at the Altumama. Korea Republic took the lead through a Son Heung-min penalty after 9 minutes. But two Jordan goals, an own goal, although perhaps it's going to be credited to Yazan Al-Arab, and that stoppage time strike from Yazan Al-Naimat means that Jordan are dreaming of the last 16 and topping the group. More to come, we hope, from this one. At the break, Jordan 2, Korea Republic 1.
Oh!
Well, welcome back to the Altamama Stadium for the second half, and we've got potentially another surprise brewing. This time in Group E, where Jordan lead the Korean Republic by 2-1. And Jurgen Klinsmann has gone to his bench at halftime and replaced Park Yong-woo in midfield with Hong Hyun-sok. And he's also withdrawn Lee Ki-jeu at left back and replaced him with Kim Tae-hwan. No changes for Jordan just yet. But no doubt some stern words in that Korean Republic dressing room at a half-time, Andy Harper.
Well, let's see what Jurgen Klinsmann could do with his Korea team. Republic team, excuse me, at half-time. A great start for them. The ball from Wang. Supposed to be a first touch of the game for Kim Tae-hwan at left fullback, but he can't control it, and it's Jordan Ball. Can Jordan maintain the raise? That was quite something, that first half.
Well, Kim Tae-hwan is known for his pace. And, of course, he's going to be up against Musa Al-Tamari. So, again, that's a little individual battle to keep an eye on. He's known as the cheetah, not C-H-E-A-T, but C-H-E-E-T-A-H. So maybe Jurgen Klinsmann feeling he's a better matchup for Al-Tamari on that side of the park.
I don't know if there's anything in this from Klinsmann's viewpoint, but it does make three of the back four all teammates at Ulsan HD.
Let's see if those changes make the difference. This is Kim Min-jae, who got the inadvertent touch on the corner from Mahmoud Almaty in the first half that produced Jordan's equaliser. Oh, what a stirring fight back from Al-Nashama. They were not going to be cowed by the reputation of the Korean Republic. Another stray pass. Misstep from Lee Jae-sung.
Yeah, misstep. I think the challenge is going to be huge for the Korean Republic if Jordan can replicate that first half. And so the discussion, Simon, I think, revolves around this pivot. We've grouped in discussion the West Asian teams that we've seen so far against the big three from East Asia, Australia, Korea, Republic, Japan. Iraq and Jordan have done incredible things. Syria lost against Australia by that singular goal. However, I think it's a good comparison discussion to have, because Syria from the get-go in that match against Australia dropped under Hector Cooper. They defended deep. They tried to string Australia out and see if they could hit them on the counter-attack. I wonder if at half-time Hector Cooper is watching this thinking, maybe I missed a trick against Australia. Because Iraq and Jordan have shown you go at these bigger, fancy teams with collectivism and passion and quality, you can turn the tables. Now, Jordan need to make sure they don't drop back and try and hold on. I believe their best line of defence is to keep attacking here. Maybe through this guy, Musa Al-Tamari.
They don't like it up them, that's what you're saying, Hubs.
To use the vernacular, yeah. Simon, yes.
And by the way, just to correct what I said earlier, that's a foul by Abdallah Nasib. Jurgen Klinsmann's actually swapped over Sol Yong-woo to the left-hand side of the defence. He's equally adept at playing left or right, and Kim Tae-hwan is starting on the right. Another stray ball.
100%. 100% of diagonal passes out to the wing since the resumption have been miscontrolled and gone out for a Jordan throw. They're clearly rattled, the Korea Republic.
Korea Republic, who have not lost a group game in Asian Cup Finals football since they were beaten 2-1 by Bahrain back in 2007. That's 11 games unbeaten in group play.
Doesn't that just continue the trend? What was Japan? 26 group match days yesterday came unstuck against the fierce Lions of Mesopotamia. I mean, it's just, it's the competition is fabulous.
And they're the great storylines that every major tournament needs.
Yeah.
Long way to go before this one is decided, though. And Jordan have a throw, which Salim Al-Ajlan will take. Looks to be shaping for the long launch. In fact, he goes short instead. This is Mahmoud Al-Mahdi, who is a little bit of an injury doubt coming into this game, but got through the first 45 okay. That's a foul by Lee Kang-in. Or on Lee Kang-in, I should say.
Yeah, Salim Al-Ajlan claiming awkwardness to the referee. I think there was a bit more intent than that.
Kim Min-jae. Put it through to Lee Jae-sung this time. So Cho Kyu-sung quite on the same page as Lee Jae-sung. Now fouled by the Korean Republic. Son offering his apologies to Nizar Al-Rashtan. We saw just towards the end of that first half, even Son Heung-min getting a little bit rattled. Misplacing passes, committing fouls.
Well, they've just done
music to the ears of Hussein Abuta.
Of course, what a job he's done. What a 45 minutes. But whilst we can bask in the 45 minutes that just gone on, as observers and fans, spectators and analysts, whichever seat we occupy, the Jordan team can't afford to bask in that glory. This Korean Republic team is too good. They're not going to be under the bushel for the entire 90 minutes unless you keep them there. And that's Jordan's challenge, I believe.
Nizar Al-Rashtan is okay. He's just become a father. His wife gave birth on the 5th of January. Plays for the Al-Faisali club, one of the big two in Jordan, although last year he was with the Iraqi club Newroz, who play in the Kurdistan region. It's clever footwork from Hassan Haddad. He was fouled for the penalty, seems a long time ago. A lot's happened since then, which he'll be relieved about. Tight in there. Now Al-Mahdi. Not really the right idea. Seen out and away by Sol Yong-woo initially. Abdallah Nasib sending it long. Al-Mahdi jostling for possession. Strong window by Kim Tae-kwon. Korea can settle things down. Jung Sung-hyun.
The most composed Korea have looked outside of the minutes leading up to and just following the penalty from Son Heung-min. The more touches they get on the ball, the better for them. The better as they seek to claw their way back. Establish parity. It's Jordan's job to make sure they don't allow them. Give a sucker an even break.
Won't get bombs. Ball out wide left to stay in play for Son Heung-min. Here's Hwang again. Better by the Koreans. Little break here for Lee Kang-in. Wide right is Kim Tae-hwan. Four in the box if he can pick one out. Here's Cho. Chance for the Koreans. Lee Jae-sung and Hwang In-bom didn't really connect properly with it, and he's not going to get a corner either.
Well, the ball finds its way to Son Heung-min and everyone stops and expects something magical. The pass off to Hwang was routine, the shot from he was not. But this is the warning now for Jordan. They've just allowed Korea more time to settle on the ball than they pretty much did the whole first half. They cannot afford to do that. The lead will evaporate. They'll be wondering why and wherefore. They're warned now. Korea Republic made their way into the Jordan penalty area relatively unchallenged. Didn't happen at all in the first half, including when they won that penalty. Conceded as it was because of the heavy fire under which Song Heung-min came from SN Hadad.
It's not a good ball by Joe Kyung-woo, the goalkeeper. Al-Tabari got the ball stuck really between his feet. Won back immediately though by Nizar Al-Rashdan. This is Haddad's. Korea can't stick hold of the ball. Al-Tamari, so cool, calm and composed.
I'll tell you what today, the change. Nour out for Jordan and Raja Ayed in.
Now the chase is on, Kim Min-jae. Was goal side, but wasn't about to take a risk.
It has been an excellent change. Raja playing in shirt 14 and Alpha Nizar in 21 have just screened that midfield so beautifully for Jordan.
Oh, we're going to see the long launch this time by Salim Al-Ajlan. He shaped to do one some minutes ago and then fooled everybody. It's longer this time, but unfortunately for Jordan, not accurate. Salim Al-Ajlan, another one from the Al-Faisaly club, playing in his second AFC Asian Cup. There's the injured goalkeeper, Kim Sung-kyu. Actually, really, the Korean media, he's headed back for surgery, unless he's already had it and flown back on that injured knee. And here to watch his teammates, and they're in the spot of bother here. Wang and Bob. Song trying to link up with Lee Jae-sung. Won back by the substitutes, Hong Hyun-suk. Who will it break for? It's Song Heung-min. Away. Gets huge roars of approval from the Jordanians.
But look, Korea starting to flex their muscles. Consecutive passes, much better touch. Getting the place changing, the player movement, the third person running, starting to click into gear. This is the long march back for the Korea Republic. How did Jordan withstand?
Squared by Wang and Bob. Searching for space. It's Wang in bomb again. Touch by Kim Min-jae. And now Sol Young-woo. Jung Sung Hyun to Lee Kang-in. Can he find a bit of magic? He's one of those to whom Jurgen Klinsmann will be looking in this second half to lift the Tiger Warriors. They're starting to make those little angle runs. The passes are starting to stick. The little combination starting to pay off. Here's Son Heung-min. Losing out there. That's what you call defending from the front by Musa Al-Tamari, and Jordan spring forwards. Al-Tamari almost impossible to shake off the ball, and he's drawn the contact. That's brilliant play by Al-Tamari.
Really is. The ball's on a string. This is a privilege to watch this guy live. The Montpellier fans in France's League One need to thank their lucky stars for doing this every week. It's virtuoso stuff. And that ball is on a string. Kim Min-jae monsters him in the end and says, "What else do I do, sir?"
And he's just taken the pressure off his team, hasn't he? Allow them to launch the ball into the box. Kim Min-jae underneath it. Nodded forward by Wang and Bob. And a foul by Rajai Ayed.
But this is so much better from the Korea Republic. They had no answer at all in that first half, but they're coming. Make no mistake, the Korea Republic is on the way back.
By the looks of the Jordanian coach, Hussein Amuta, I think he agrees with you. They need to find a solution, Jordan, quickly. Does he perhaps go to his bench? He's resisted that temptation so far, Omuta. This is Jung Song-hyun. Now Hong Hyun-sok. Moved wide by Kim Min-jae. Quang Yun-bom allowed to advance unchecked. Song Hyun-min with a little layoff. They've got the combinations going. It's Son that's blocked. But Jordan sat ever deeper. Now they look to spring forward. Al-Tamari is the outlet. Kim Min-jae has him covered.
But there's no urgency from Jordan in his second half to fill in those gaps in behind the lead runner, which there was in the first half. They're already looking intent to sit back and protect. And it's potentially a perilous state of mind. The game was really only theirs to want to be won with their first half performance. But they're just allowing the Korea Republic to edge forward, get into their touch, give and go, place changing.
Son Heung-min's ball. Can Kim Tae-hwan keep it alive? Not quite. I said he was quick. Not quite that quick.
He gave it a go. It's a lot to expect against a team like this. For Jordan to dismount the rear guard action. Not impossible, of course. It can be very, very effective and frustrating for the opposition, but there's such quality in this Korea team.
And we've seen in the past that Jordan claimed big scalps, defeated Australia a couple of times in World Cup qualifiers, and as you can hear in the stands as well, this is like a home game for Jordan. They cannot afford to sit too deep too early. Brought down here by Al Naimat, scorer of their second goal. Haddad's no way through.
It's been an incredible start to the second half from Hwang In-byeom to South Korea Republic's deep line midfielder. Here he is in possession. He's really turned the dial for his team, actually. That and the slightly altered approach from Jordan has shifted the lens on this football match. You're not going to take your eyes off this one, not for a second.
Hwang In-byeom is another one of the overseas-based contingent for Jurgen Klinsmann, plays in Serbia for Red Star Belgrade. Actually scored a UEFA Champions League goal just last month against Manchester City in a 3-2 loss. They've got quality all over the field, the Korean Republic. And it's they who are now controlling the pattern of the game, if not yet the scoreboard. Min-jae to set in train a Korean attack.
That's better. They're working their rotations much better, switching the ball, the touch has improved. Look at that one.
Lovely control by Lee Jae-sung. This is Kim Tae-hwan. Cross charge down. Another go for Kim Tae-hwan. Quite sits for Lee Kang-in. And look how deep Jordan are camped in their own half. Offsides. Well, play continues for the moment, and everybody stopped, and it's scooped over the top anyway by Cho Kyu-sung. The flag went up early, and everybody stood like statues for a moment.
That we have avoided a massively contentious moment here. The assistants are told, as we know, don't put your flag up. But his training He's seen an offside, he's put his flag. Everyone stopped, and I would have stopped too. And if they score there...
Whoa.
Well, if they score there, it would have come back, would have been rubbed out anyway. What mightn't have happened, however, with the play waved on, was some other calamity. Depends on the scale, of course. Now, that was confusing. That's nail-biting. But the fans are still smiling, if nervous.
I'm sure the Jordan fans were smiling at that particular moment. More clutching their worry beads. It's been a difficult 20 minutes, but they've survived it so far. But for how long? Here come the Koreans. It's Cho Kyu-sung. Lost his balance and the ball. Jordan survive, and there are spaces for them to attack. On the charge, Nizar Al-Rashtan. Going down the left, he has Mahmoud Al-Mahdi alongside. And it was all too easy in the end.
This is the key difference. They're making those marginal decisions and they're not coming off in this second half. First half, they pretty much didn't miss a beat. Now the field's open for the Korean Republic to charge upfield.
Son Heung-min with another pass that wasn't exactly top quality, but Korea Republic still have it through their talisman. Cho on the end is deflected, and it'll come all the way through to Kim Tae-hwan. Now with Hong Kyun-sok, going to try and blast one from long range, pushed away by Abu Leila. Hwang In-bom squares it up. Son Heung-min, is this the moment for the Koreans? Calls for handball, only half-hearted from the Korean Republic. But they are coming, the Taeguk Warriors.
Well, in some ways, this is the shot from Lee Kang-in, beaten away by Yazid. The fans of the EPL, I'm sure there are many, who are watching Son play in national team red. Now, this second half is taking shape like Son playing for Spurs. The attack in massed ranks around the opposing penalty area. The slide passes in behind the fence for overlapping players, and then the cutback for the tap-in. He's been doing it all season, Son, in North London, and is looking for the same response from his compatriots here against Jordan, behind as they are, remarkably.
Jordan have just got a problem with goalkeeper Yazid Abu Leila at the moment. Bit of an issue with the left shoulder, and it appears that the Korean Republic are going to go to their bench once again and introduce Jong Woo-young, the number 17, and the number 20 there is Oh Hyun-kyu, who plays his club football in Scotland with Celtic. Here's how Son Heung-min set the ball rolling in terms of the goals. And we thought that might be the signal for an onslaught, but it wasn't to be. An own goal from Kim Min-jae squared the ledger. And then in first half stoppage time, Yazan Al-Naimat with a very controlled, composed finish into the corner. And that's the way it has stayed. Changes for the Korean Republic. Oh Hyun-kyu and Jong Woo-young. There's Son's penalty again, and he went off to not only celebrate but pay tribute to his stricken colleague Kim Sung-kyu. There he is in the stands.
Well, interesting subs. From Jurgen Klinsmann. Cho of Midtjylland in Denmark is replaced by Oh, who's a bruising centre-forward for Celtic. Razan Al Arab has seen one imposing physical specimen off. Now he's got to deal with Oh Pyongyu.
And Jong Woo Yong on as well, attacking midfielder from Stuttgart, another one who plays in the Bundesliga. The ball briefly found its way through to Al Tamari on that right hand side, but just a little slip. Offside against Son Heung-min. Have they weathered the storm, Jordan?
Well, that lengthy stop for the goalkeeper, Yazid, will have helped in that register, but you know, that's going to deny the fact that South Korea are likely to get straight back on the horse and come charging again, which they do. The front three pushing up to force the long ball. Kim Min-jae dealing with that long ball. This is the pattern. Then the play starts with Hwang In-byung, and they spread wide. This is the trigger point now for the place changing, the player rotation, the give and go.
Little deflection there by Hwang In-byung, keeps the attack alive for the Korean Republic. Lee Kang-in works it out for Kim Tae-hwan, and the cross is soon behind by Ahsan Haddad for a corner.
Huge change. Kane's changed completely. Change time now, speaking off for Jordan, or soon.
Mohamed Abu Hashish. Another defender's going to be thrown on shortly. Meantime, here's the corner from Lee Kang-in, but that's going to be comfortable enough for Abu Leila,
who again will try and take some heat out of the game. But as we've seen, Korea Republic will come straight back. Look at the pressure on the ball now. It's desperation stakes, as it needs to be. And with the back door even slightly ajar, can Jordan hit them for a third time? They've got the corner now. And they're under no hurry.
It's going to be a double change for Jordan. And they do make those substitutions. We're going to see Fadi Awad as well, who's a defensive midfielder, who plays his club football in Malaysia. And Mohamed Abu Hashish is a left-back who plays for Hetz in Lebanon. So two defensive changes. The message perhaps clear. What we have, we try to hold. A third goal they'd love. Here's Al Tamari towards the near post. Not completely away. Snapshots from Nizar Al-Rashdan. Well held by Jo Hyun-woo.
But no sooner do they turn to run back than they realise here comes the red tide now. Again, as soon as they can, the ball centralises to Hwang before it goes to either flank, and then the circus starts.
Al-Tamari must buy his team a few seconds. Done brilliantly. How about that? I think he played for that. Just chipped it up onto the arm of his opponent. There's that previous shot from Al-Rashdan, which was at a comfortable height for the goalkeeper.
It's the first real bit of work that Joe's had to do in this second half.
Here's the changes. Abu Hashish for Mahmoud Al-Mahdi. Was carrying that injury into the game today. I don't think he's in any particular hurry to go off. Maybe a bit of time wasting here. And Rajai Ayed gets his number called as well. Fadi Awad, his replacement. Hashish in particular will just give them a little bit more defensive solidity on the left-hand side. Al-Mahdi, much more of an attacking type of player. But for all the Korean Republic's pressure, really that one save for Abu Leila from Lee Kang-in. We're approaching the final quarter of an hour at the Al Tumama. Kim Tae-hwan to sling it out towards the far left-hand side, but it's too high for Son.
It's the first one they've missed, in fairness to the Korea Republic. We recall the start of the half, the first three passes that went out to the flank bounced out for throw-ins. But since then, they've pretty much been on point. Don't they just love Son?
Well, they need a bit of magic from him. He's there to rescue this game. And, of course, their hopes of finishing top of Group E. Nice skills by Lee Kangin. Up and away by Haddad. A reset through Jung Sung Hyun. Lee Kangin to Kim Tae Hwan. Nice little ball through from Kwang In Bom, who's had a good game in the centre of the park. Son plays in his teammate on the left, but it's plucked out of the air by Yazid Babalola, and Jordan survive another raid.
This is so instructive. Look at the players in motion, including the overlap. Once he's opted for that little chip pass, the keeper's always the favourite.
Plays in the second division in Saudi Arabia, Yazid Abulayla for Al Jabalan. And his goalkeeping coach we remember well as well, Andy, Amir Shafi. The goalkeeper they called the Whale. Now retired, but still helping out. Free kick, Jordan. And a little bit of descent shown.
Seoul.
By Seoul.
Dong-woo doesn't, I think, believes he didn't make any contact with Altamari.
Well, it was the throwing up of the arms after the awards that referee Salman Falahi took exception to.
Yeah, descent by action. But I'm with him, actually. I didn't see any contact. We got Foxed. Play again from Altamari.
Set long by Abdallah Nassi. Jordan looking to feed off the second ball, and they've done so. Inviting Abu Hashish forward, the substitute. It'll be a Jordan throw. And again, they'll just take as much time as they can. There's a chance for Ali Olwan. Well, that would have been a back page headline.
Yeah, that's a speculator, I think it's fair to say. But in the context of this second half, this is a little bit of a breathing spell for Jordan. Only momentarily, though, because here come the Dogwood Warriors again.
Son Heung-min leading the charge. Angled out to the left for Seoul. Inside is Hwang In Bom. Little flick by Son Heung-min. They get to the byline again, but sent over the top of the bar by Jong Woo-yong.
Yeah, he's been busy since he's come on, Jong. But they haven't found that last pass. Everything else, from a Korea Republic viewpoint, is going to script. It's beautiful that the interplay, the combinations. But at that point, time after time, they haven't found a solution, haven't found the pass, haven't been able to get someone free to shoot. And every time they call check on Jordan, Jordan make a move out.
That nine-game unbeaten run of the Korean Republic is under serious threat. Last lost in June last year to Peru. Son Heung-min going around the outside. It's a dangerous ball in low, but well defended again. Well, Arab at the near post. But they're tiring Jordan. Can they hang on? Worked out wide by Hwang In Bom. This is Jong Woo-yong. Invited forward is Seol Yong-woo. Sees off one defender. Time to measure the cross. Back post is Lee Kang-in. There's a white wall in front of him, and it does its job once more. But for how much longer can they repel these attacks? The breaks here for Ola Ashton. Well played, Nizar Al-Rashtan. Haddad. Spectacular action cleared by Kim Min-jae.
It's breathless stuff here. It's
here
breathless.
Goes Son. Being pursued relentlessly by Abdullah Nassim. What a tackle.
The double fist pump.
What a tackle.
And that's been a leading cast here today. Not a poor player on the field for either team, but Nizar Al-Rashtan, the number 21 for Jordan, is close to the best on the field. And there's been...
Here's Jongwoo Yong. Created space nicely for the opportunity. That could not keep it down.
Yeah, there's a lot of candidates for that top gong for the game. Nizar Al-Rashtan has been incredible. This needs to be way more control. This is a rare thing. Not the leader, because those angle passes just outside the penalty area is most of the ground that the Korea Republic look to take, but they don't get such a clear effort at the end of it, not until now at least. And Jong blazes away.
Well, Jordan, who have defended manfully, just gulping in a few big ones, and they need it. Some of the players looking visibly tired, but still they hold the lead over Jurgen Klinsmann's Korea Republic. What a famous win this would be for Al Nashaba.
Well, there's another two reinforcements waiting on the sideline for Jordan.
Maybe Ibrahim Sade. And also Anas Hamad. This is Sol Yong-woo. Korean Republic probing, pushing, trying to find space. This is Lee Kang-in. Again, charged down. It breaks nicely for Son Heung-min. It spins away from him. Lee Kang-in, beaten away by the goalkeeper. Desperate defending by Jordan. Still, it's not away. Jordan have got a man down injured inside the box. And the whistle has gone. And now there are two who dropped to their knees, maybe not just with injuries, but through sheer exhaustion.
It could be. And more than a passing hint of just trying to suck some of the oxygen out of the time. But it's not sucking any oxygen out of the atmosphere. That's a really difficult one to save. Yes, it does brilliantly. You saw the late dip as Lee Kang-in fires the ball in with that beautiful left foot of his.
Abu Hashish got a whack to the arm. In that goalmouth scramble, there's the two substitutes awaiting their moment. And their instructions, probably pretty basic, Andy. Keep them out. And the medicos were rather slow to arrive on the field.
Well, they've given themselves every chance, the Korea Republic, in this second half. Blown away in that first half. Here's the injury. Oh, going for the volley.
And connecting only with the arm of Abu Hashish. The end of the section for Nizar Al-Rashtan, who's played part.
He needs to take a bow, Simon. It's been superhuman from him. And quality. Just an incredible, incredible performance. He's just realised it's his turn off. He can be very, very proud of what he's done today.
Ibrahim Sade, his replacement, who plays his club football here in Qatar with Al-Khor. And they're also going to replace the man who at the moment is the match winner, Yazan Al-Naymat.
He's been excellent too. Two moments from Yazan Al-Naymat. The goal, of course, that'll be replayed. That was a beautiful bit of adjustment technically. But the pass he put on to open that whole opportunity for Musa Al-Tamari was enough for me to lose control at the moment. It doesn't happen often. It was a moment that gets people out of their seat. Incredible two contributions.
So Ibrahim Sade and Anas Al-Awadat are the two changes for Al-Rashdan and Al-Naimat. Just over 5 minutes of the regulation, 90 minutes left, but there will be a fair chunk of stoppage time to be added on. This is Al-Awadat with his first involvement in the game. Fresh legs. The shot is charged down by Kim Min-jae. Korean Republic desperate to find an equaliser. They've had almost all the play in this second half. They are not easy to break down. Here's one of the substitutes, Fadi Awet, aiming for the top corner, and he wasn't too far away. That would have sealed it, probably.
Well, and this was a rare thing in this second half. The midfielder breaking to read the play here. All half, that ball has gone off the head of Kim Min-jae to Hwang, and they've started playing. But Fadi Awet has come on with the instruction. See if you can intercept that first pass to Hwang, which he does. He got a bit of a nosebleed then, actually. He was really tempted to give the ball to the star, Musa Al-Tamari. He got so close to the penalty area, he backed himself to shoot. But they had numbers well in advance of Korea Republic's defensive capability at that point. That could have been a third, and that could have been game, set and match. But these subs have really added some spark for the Jordan team.
Work wide by Lee Kang-in. This is Kim Tae-hwan hitting the byline and earning his team a corner.
What a football match. What a football match, Simon. What a privilege to be able to watch this with these tens of thousands of fury fans.
Lee Kang-in has taken that corner before his teammates were even ready. Extraordinary.
It is. There's a breakdown. The first breakdown of the second half, really. And they'll take as long as they can to get this game restarted from the goalkeeper, Jordan. What a coaching performance this has been from Hussein Amuta, the Moroccan. And what a performance by his team. We're approaching the 90 minutes. There will be a chunk of stoppage time.
Well, it will leave, if it stays this way, the Korean Republic needing to get a result against Malaysia on the 25th of January. They'll be confident of doing that, of course, to go through. But Jordan would then be heavy favourites to win the group. They may even do so tonight. If Malaysia can do them a favour against Bahrain. And their fans are in raptures at this performance. They weren't rattled by falling behind after just 9 minutes, that Son Heung-min penalty. They were aggressive in the first half and they've been resolute in the second. This is Hwang In-bom, touched by Jong Woo-yong. Wide left it goes. The boos ring out from the Jordanian fans. Korea Republic have to settle for a throw, which Seol Yong-woo is in a hurry to take. This is Hong Yun-sok. Seol Yong-woo. Down that left-hand side, but Jordan trying very hard to shut down the spaces. The acrobatics from Fadi Awet only partly away. More distance on that clearing header. And more valuable seconds tick away.
It's been a while since Jordan have been able to find Musa Al-Tamari. They've been under a lot of pressure, but let's just see Jordan's number 10. If he can emerge as we go into stoppage time. There shouldn't be that much stoppage time, really.
So Yong-woo leaves it for Jong, and that'll be claimed by Yazid Abulela.
They're nearly there. What will be the latest in a potted history of stirring performances from Jordan? They haven't had good form on the field. I'll tell you what, they've got good form over the years of pulling out these performances, encouraged by the most incredible fan base.
And what will be the fallout for Jurgen Klinsmann? Already not exactly Mr. Popular amongst certain segments of the Korean media republic, but they've got 11 minutes, a whopping 11 minutes to try and turn it around. This is Kim Tae-hwan towards the near post, glanced on. Son Heung-min will retrieve it. Hwang In-bom calling for it, top of the box. It's Hwang In-bom, deflected in. Own goal off Al-Ajlin, I think. And we're all square in the first of 11 minutes of stoppage time. 2-2. And Jordan's hearts are broken.
And Korea's Republic's fans have found their voice. They've had to play second fiddle till now, but they're not second fiddle anymore. They're back level. Not a lost cause. The ball bounces out to Son Heung-min, who just steadies the ship and angles the ball back for Hwang. And his shot towards goal is helped in by the guy who forced the own goal at the other end of the field, Yazan Al-Arab, who's been excellent today. There has been a sense of the inevitable in this second goal, as strongly as Jordan have held out. The Korea Republic were coming and coming and coming, and they've just come right to the fore in stoppage time, and still more time to come. By the way, just in passing, I think 11 minutes is probably the largest chunk of stoppage time we've had in the tournament.
I do wonder, Andy,
there's been no VAR in the second half.
When the board went up, whether the Jordanian players looked at that and went,
maybe, that's a good point. A very interesting twist on that, Simon. But there's been no VAR correct in this second half. No goals until now. Only substitutions.
One or two stoppages for injuries.
11 minutes worth. Anyway, as just observers, you take as much of this as you can get.
And I bet that was a big sigh of relief we were seeing on the face of Jurgen Klinsmann.
Well, if pressure told on Kim Min-jae for his own goal in that first half, so too the guy who put him under that pressure in the first half for that second goal, Yazan Al-Arab, who stuck his toe in, rather tired as it was, to deny Hwang. Can they deny Korea Republic a third?
Threaded through by Son. Lee Kang-in just had too many bodies in front of him. So they'll work it back towards Hwang In-bom. And the shot from Oh Hyun-kyu. Way wide.
Well, he's just copped a mouthful from his captain, Son Heung-min. Here's the goal. Hwang has been great today. That's tired and unfortunate. See, when you're not tired, you're defending on the front foot, which they've done for most of the game, but the weariness has pushed them back. He was off balance as he went to deflect the ball out of habit, away from his goal, but he's been huge for his team today. And can they find the reserves, necessary reserves, to finish with something, Jordan? Because it's all Korea Republic at the moment.
Hwang In-bom, who's had a very good game in midfield for the Korean Republic, has taken his leave. There's his replacement, Park Jin-sup. Plays his club football in the K-League for the Jeonbuk Motors. And probably that's not just tiredness, but also to protect him, because he did pick up a yellow card in the first half, Hwang In-bom, and he's very important to the way Korea Republic play. But in terms of the group, that still leaves, by my maths, Jordan on top with the better goal difference, but that could change. Head-to-head is the first tiebreaker. Well, that's ruled out, because if they finish level here, that that's out of the window. Goal difference is next. And Jordan still have the advantage for now in that regard. Going into the final match day.
This is an incredible, this is a World Cup type atmosphere, Simon. There's good numbers of Korean Republic fans who are screaming their lungs out, and we've heard most of the afternoon from the Jordan side of the equation, but they've been muted for the time being at least.
Yellow card shown to Oh Hyun Kyu. He's perhaps still a little bit frustrated that he didn't do better with that chance he had some moments ago, and just went in way too rashly for that one. On Altamari. So he picks up a booking. We've still got a decent chunk of stoppage time to play. Forward towards Brahim Sade. And Jordan get a throw. A point, still a good result for them.
Oh, in a lot of ways, a fair outcome. Such was the quality of their first half. It's been all hands to the pump in this second half, as the Korea Republic has really got the bit between their teeth. And still time to win it. Still 6 minutes, 5 or 6 minutes.
Is Kim Tae-hwan. Slung wide by Lee Kang-in. Here's Son Heung-min. Jung Woo-yong. And Park Jin-sop. Kang-in finding a little bit of room. Jordan getting numbers back behind the ball. And the substitute's going to have to go on his own. He's got precious little help. And Asala Wadatani's drawn the foul. Got a free kick, which just relieves that bit of pressure.
And that's
again
the value of the fresh legs. I mean, he's been good since he's come on. And Asama, it was a powerful charge out of defence and then just cooled things down. Wins the free kick. A breather for Jordan. It's the cue for the Jordan fans now to pipe up.
Touch by Fadi Owens. Trying to get Altamari going instead. The Koreans are quickly back on the attack. Great challenge by Nassim. What a game he's had.
Excellent, but Son Heung-min's not happy. He wanted that ball early from the substitute striker, Ho.
A barge into the face of Oh Hyun Kyu by Fadi Owens.
Yeah, I should say injudicious at this point of the game. Just reaching in.
Slap across the chops, wasn't it?
Unnecessarily. It puts the defence under enormous pressure. Lee Kang-in will put some work on this ball. He's got a beautiful left foot, the PSG man. Watch him put some work on this.
The boos from the Jordanian fans. The game is on a knife edge. Jordan have defended stoutly. Is quality going to tell at the end? Lee Kang-min's delivery only partly away, pushed away at the back post and jabbed into the side netting. Wow. Hong Hyun-sok at the back post couldn't deflect it through the post.
Well, a couple of chances. It's a wicked dip and curl on that ball. Look at the anticipation. Look at the anticipation from Park Jin-sop. Himself off the bench, so excited at the potential that he's put on the winning goal. But Hong Hyun-sok on the far post at full stretch and completely desperately gets to the ball but can only steer it wide.
Well, there's 90 seconds to go. Have Jordan done enough to get something from a very good rearguard display in the second half? They're not quite there yet. Could it get even better for them? Musa Al-Tamari up against Kim Min-jae. Still Al-Tamari, but Min-jae is too wily, too strong. And now Korea Republic spring forward through Son Heung-min, but good tackle again by Abdallah Nasib, who has been everywhere.
Hasn't he been enormous for his team? Oh, they've all been enormous. It's been quite the game.
Forward by Alada. There's no flag yet. Lee Kang-min races onto it. Two in the middle. Make that three now. It's too deep the cross. Now the flag goes up. I fancied that Lee Kang-min might have been offside.
It might have. It would have made for an interesting replay, though, with the lines out and the set squares. But to the eye.
Maybe Abu Hashish is playing him on, but
we go with the view of the assistant referee, which is like the old days. And fair enough too. It's a relieving offside free kick for Jordan. They'll take the point at this stage, I'd reckon.
Well, we're into the 12th minute of stoppage time now, and there can't be too much more. Sent forward by Abu Layla. Drop here for Jordan. Anas Alawadat to his fellow substitutes, Ibrahim Saadeh, who is bundled over, and Jordan will have a free kick. Have they got ambition to try and send it forward and try and win the game?
They can't be. This must be the last action of the match, you'd imagine. Is that a wry smile, a nervous smile? How many minutes are we playing, sir?
Do Korea have time to spring forwards and create one last chance? Oh, it timed his run well enough, but the ball didn't have the requisite quality.
It's excellent goalkeeping from Yazid to read that.
And we're into the 13th minute of added time. Korea Republic have a throw. How much longer do we play on?
The ref must be doing this one with an egg timer. A stopwatch.
We might be here all night. And we're here for it, Harps. It's been a great game.
Oh, it's been a magnificent experience, this. Magnificent.
Here's Sol Yong-woo. The whistles from the Jordanian fans. They want time to be blown, but no indication from the ref as yet that he's about to blow his whistle. Here's Hong Hyun-sok to Kim Tae-hwan. Maybe both teams are settling for the point. Jung Sung-hyun. And now the full-time whistle blows. That was, ladies and gentlemen, one heck of a game of football. Goodness me. Son Heung-min with the opener from the spot. Two goals by Jordan. An own goal from Kim Min-jae, and Yazan Al-Naimat gave Jordan a chance of springing another big shot, but a goal in stoppage time. An own goal from Al-Arab gives the Korea Republic a share of the spoils. Jordan stay top of the group for now. That was one that will be remembered for a long, long time. But Korea Republic extend their unbeaten record in Asian Cup Finals football to 12 matches. And the only word left for us to say is, phew, that was epic. Full time at the Altamama. Jordan 2, Korea Republic 2.